word and his instruments of music brought before him. And his sleep went from him. And then the king arose very early in the morning and went in haste unto the den of the lions. And when he came to the den, he cried with a lamentational voice unto Daniel. And the king spake and said to Daniel, O Daniel, servant of the living God, is thou God, whom thou servest continually, able to deliver thee from the lion? Then said Daniel unto the king, O king, live forever. My God, somebody say my God, had sent his angels to shut the lion's mouth, that they have not hurt me, for as much as before him innocence was found in me, and also before thee, O king, have I done no hurt? Then was the king exceedingly glad for him, and commanded that they should take Daniel up out of the den. So Daniel was taken out of the den, and no manner of hurt was found upon him, because, somebody say because, he believed in his God. Amen. A reason to commitment, part two. Reason for commitment. Daniel, in our contemporary and current culture, it brings new challenges every day to our Christian faith. Every day, there's new challenges to our Christian faith. Every day, questions about our faith, challenges to our faith. Each passing day, this culture, this current culture, bring challenges to our Christian faith. And just like us today, Daniel, each passing day, this young man had to grow up in a culture that was contrary to his traditional family value. And he unexpectedly found himself caught up in a culture that was foreign to him. Everything was strange. Everything was not known to him. His value system, his family upbringing, his church upbringing, his teaching from the one and only true God, his system of worship, the system that he had developed to worship God was challenged. His value system, his true claims, his moral compass was changed greatly, was challenged greatly every which way he turned. Every day his moral conscience was challenged, because he was caught up in a world that he had not grown up in. He believed in the one and only true God. Daniel believed that God was able. Daniel believed that God can do anything. Daniel believed that God is the one and only true God. He believed that only God should be worshipped. They thought of that. They thought him the Shema, which is, when they start off, every day the Jew would say that, O Israel, worship thou only the one and only true God. Don't you worship no other God. They told him that. They told him that. Parents would teach him that. Every morning, Daniel would get up, and every day he would pray. Every day he would pray to that one and only true God. He believed that God would take care of him if he would worship him. Yes. He believed that God would answer his prayer if he would pray. Yes. He believed that if he kept his commitment, if he kept his promise, if he kept on worshiping God and being true to God, that God would take care of him. Yes. He believed that. believed that every which way he turned, no matter if he had to go across the country, Daniel did not change who he was. Wherever he would go, wherever he was sent at, you know, and he was trained to go to those places because he had to go to those places because he had to work for the king. But everywhere he went, Daniel never did change who he was. Amen, somebody? When you're a man, was an engineer, and his wife was a professor at Baylor University. And they were members of Carl Park Baptist Church in Waco, Texas, and he came to me to minister, and he asked me one time, he said, "Rev, is it all right if we could, my wife and I can go and sit down and listen to some light jazz, sit in the club, sit down for a little while and listen to some jazz?" And I said, "Son, you can do what you got to do. But all I'm going to tell you is remember who you are and whom you belong to. And remember my late pastor said, you go all out there doing Mardi Gras at a parade. Amen? But don't forget who you are and to whom you belong to. Your people, I don't paint you that so much that life got to offer. God has been so good to us, and I'm saying today, as African Americans, African Americans, but you know, I grew up in the 60s, we call ourselves brothers and sisters, we call ourselves colored folks, but we told our parents, said, don't use those words, that's a racist word, don't say colored folks. We will say black people, amen? We have come a long way. God has been good to us. We go places that we were not allowed to go to before. We go places that we didn't have the money to go to. Amen? Praise the Lord, somebody. I'm sitting down in the room with Chris Steakhouse. You gave us a gift card. And my wife and I was in Florida. And that man was explaining the menu to us. And we were sitting down. Those kind of things. And God has been good to us. But let me tell you something, just because God has been good to us, we ought to remember why and where did this good thing come. All good things come from above. I look to the hill for which cometh my help. Somebody gonna help me up here. And all my help comes from the Lord. It's to God belongs the glory. To God belongs the honor. To God belongs all of the praise and all of the worship. What should I render unto him? Amen, somebody? What could I give to God for what God has done for me? Hallelujah, somebody. He wakes me up every morning. Gave me life every morning. Brand new day every morning. Activities on my limbs every morning. Got clothes on my back, shoes on my foot, rope on my feet, roof over my head. Got a car riding. Ain't God been good? Hallelujah, somebody. Hallelujah, somebody. Woke up at 8:30 the other morning. I said, "Ain't no man, Lord, have mercy." I said, "God is good." Just because I woke up at 8:30, well, I used to have to get up at 4 o'clock. And all